Grafting several different fruit varieties in the same tree can be a very effective way of using available space in a small backyard orchard. One of the ways of achieving this is by regrafting an unwanted single variety fruit tree using one of several grafting techniques like bark grafting. Having two or three different fruits in the same tree can provide variety and allow the grower to enjoy them throughout the season. However, this approach can have several drawbacks and problems when compared with the traditional option of having one fruit tree with a single variety. The first problem is the possibility of unproductive tree sections, since different grafted varieties tend to require different conditions, like specific pollination partners or a high number of cold hours in the winter. In this example, this pear tree was grafted with three different French pears. Since a friend told me these were three very good old French varieties, I decided to graft them to the main branches of the same tree as soon as I received the scions. I didn't research a bit more about each variety requirements and characteristics as I usually do. As the grafted tree started to produce fruits, I soon realized I had made a mistake, since the productivity of each variety is very different in my area. While Sucre de Montluçon is extremely productive, to the point of requiring heavy thinning each year or risk branch breaking with the weight of all the fruits, the other two varieties are a different matter. Comtesse de Paris produces only a few fruits each year. As for Bourrée Superfin, one or two fruits or none at all are the norm. So, care must be taken when choosing which varieties to graft in each situation. Poor production problems are usually related to different development cycles between the grafted varieties. Different varieties should break dormancy and flower at similar dates, or the lack of adequate pollination can be responsible for poor crops. Most varieties of many different fruit types are not self-fertile, which means they need to cross-pollinate with other compatible varieties to produce fruits. So, by grafting varieties that break winter dormancy and flower at the same time, the chances of avoiding productivity problems will increase. I have more than 30 different pear varieties in my orchard, covering all flower pollination groups. I also have several beehives in close proximity with the orchard, so lack of adequate pollinators is quite certainly not the problem. The main culprit is probably the lack of chill hours, that is, enough cold hours below 7 degrees centigrade in the winter that are necessary for these varieties to break dormancy and successfully produce flowers and fruits. Even when some varieties seem to flower at the same time, insufficient lower temperatures might cause incorrect development of the flowers and harm pollination success. This might explain the lack of fruits on the varieties that need more winter cold, even when they appear to flower normally. When choosing varieties to graft to a multi-varieties tree, you might be tempted to choose some with very different maturity dates. That would seem like a good idea, since it would extend that particular fruit type season throughout the year. However, the more the maturity date is different between each variety, chances are the chill requirement for each one is also very different, possibly affecting dormancy length and flowering periods. An early variety tends to break dormancy and flower early in the season, while a late variety tends to stay dormant much longer and flower several weeks later. If you don't have any more trees of the same fruit type, pollination might be difficult or impossible between grafted varieties with different cold requirements. Chances are that when one late variety starts flowering, the early ones might have already set fruits and stopped producing flowers and pollen. So, a desire to extend the season by grafting very early and very late varieties for a determined fruit type must be followed by adequate research on flowering dates and chill requirements of each one. If the requirements are very different, it may be impossible to have adequate productivity between all the grafted varieties depending on your zone, like in my 3 French pears fruit tree. Another common problem with multi-varieties fruit trees has to do with differences in vigor between grafted varieties. It's not uncommon that one variety is much more vigorous than the others. If not kept in check by heavy pruning, this single variety might take over and use most of the rootstock resources. Two vigorous varieties may induce development delays in the others or even cause them to wither and dry out in extreme cases. So, it's essential to control the growth of each graft, even by summer pruning if needed, to avoid tree imbalance. If left unchecked, a single vigorous variety will most likely take over the tree resources and the others won't be able to develop or produce adequately. The same problem can happen if you graft different varieties in different seasons. The older grafts, even if the grafted varieties are not excessively vigorous, will prevent the new ones from growing at a normal pace. To avoid this problem, try to graft all the varieties at the same time whenever possible. A final warning when multi-varieties fruit trees are concerned has to do with the final tree aesthetics. Since there is always a chance for different dormancy, flowering and fruit setting periods between grafted varieties, multi-varieties trees can look a bit strange and asymmetric during the season. Some branches might be fully awake, with leaves, flowers and even fruits, while others might still be dormant. So, if an aesthetically symmetric and balanced tree is imported to you, avoid grafting varieties with different requirements in the same tree, or you might not like the end result. Not all combinations will be pleasing to the eye, like this pear tree, where both grafted varieties have similar dormancy, flowering and fruit setting periods. If you experiment grafting many different varieties like this 7-in-1 example, the final tree will have very awkward looking moments during the spring, for sure. But aesthetics aside, the end result is well worth it, in my opinion. Check the channel for detailed videos on grafting and pruning techniques for fruit trees. If you appreciate my work, like, subscribe, share the video and leave a comment to help me make more. Click the bell and turn on notifications on your device so you don't miss my next videos. Thanks for watching.